What's up, guys? Big Natural Stoney Keeley here for another edition of Yankee Candle Reviews on Sobros Network. We're going to be wrapping up our discussion of summer fragrances for the season today, talking about Yankee Candle's Moonlit Cove. Get you a better look at that artwork. So like Cliffside Sunrise, Moonlit Cove is also a part of Yankee's The Last Paradise collection. And I got to tell you, they are on one with this line because this is good summertime scents. But why believe me when you can sense for yourself? That's good. And that's different from a lot of their other summertime fragrances. It's not overly beachy, coconutty. It's not floral. It's not fruity. It's soft per Yankee Candle. Slip away to a hidden cove where the moonlight sparkles on the water, while notes of lemongrass, ginger, and woodsy botanicals enchant the senses. So they're saying it's notes of lemongrass, ginger, nutmeg, rainbow eucalyptus, sea-washed amber, cedar leaf. That's good shit. I gotta give them credit for really going out of the box on this one. You know what it smells like to me? It smells like you're at Club La Vila, Panama City Beach, 1997, and you've just taken a big whiff of the exotic perfume of a person that you just know you're going to have casual sex with in the Waffle House bathroom later. That's Moonlit Cove. I think you're clear to burn this one all summer long, but I will say it's a nice nighttime fragrance. This isn't going to make you want to have drinks on the beach. It's not going to remind you of the hot sun. They really do a good job of sort of encapsulating a nighttime sort of fragrance within this candle. I've burned it all summer long. It's quickly become one of my summertime favorites. And I got to say, this Lost Paradise collection, championship move from Yankee Candle. My recommendation, of course, is to burn this while you're doing someone from behind or getting done from behind.